Hello learners, welcome back to EduRev. I hope you remember what all we studied in the last lecture about microorganisms. We studied that what are microorganisms, and then we studied about various types of microorganisms, that is protozoa, bacteria, fungi, algae, and finally about viruses. So now tell me, do you people know that how these microorganisms can be our friends? Can you tell me this? Well, if you do not know the answer of this question, then do not worry. We will be studying and decoding this question in this lecture itself. So, before moving on to the first topic, let's see what is our session plan. So, we will study that where do these microorganisms, which we talked about in the previous lecture, actually live. Then we will see how these microorganisms can be our friends. And we will also see the uses of bacteria and yeast. Then we are going to talk about antibiotics, vaccines, and finally about the cleaning of the environment by these microorganisms. So let's move forward without further ado with our first topic. That is, where do these microorganisms live? Now, can you people tell me that in this particular picture, which is a picture of a park, can you locate all the microorganisms which are there? Well, the answer is no, you cannot. Because all the microorganisms cannot be seen with your naked eye. So you just cannot see all the microorganisms with your naked eye. And do you know where these microorganisms could actually live? Now, microbes can survive in all kinds of environments. From icy cold climates to hot springs, that is any kind of temperature, and deserts to even marshy lands, that is any level of humidity. Now, do you people know that some of these microorganisms might live independently while others live as parasite, that is inside the bodies of other organisms including animals and food? Now, just picture this. Suppose you are in a lab and it's a very, very clean lab. Can you tell that is there any kind of microbe or microorganism that is inside that lab? Well, the answer is yes. How? There are so many microorganisms which will be inside your body itself. You can have bacteria, viruses, parasites, fungi, even the oral microbes inside your body. And all these microorganisms will be there inside your body when you will be there in the lab. So even if there is no microorganisms, which is never going to happen, that there is no microorganism in the lab, but still there are going to be so many microorganisms inside your body itself. That means these microorganisms are literally everywhere. So now let's see how these microorganisms connect with us and how they actually affect our life in a very, very good way. Firstly, they help in commercial purposes, that is production of bread, alcohol, curd and cheese. And the production of bread is actually done with the help of yeast, and the production of alcohol also. The production of curd is done by lactobacillus bacteria. And we are actually going to study how the production of bread, alcohol and curd happens in the further lecture. Next, we have that these microorganisms help to increase the fertility of the soil. That is, fungi and bacteria break down complex minerals into simpler forms, and they actually help in what? In increasing the fertility of the soil. Then they also help in medicinal uses. That is, they help in production of antibiotics like streptomycin. They also help in production of vaccines like polio vaccine. And they also help in formation of tablets like vitamin B complex tablets from yeast and bacteria. And finally, these microorganisms also help in the cleaning of environment. That is, microorganisms help in decomposition of dead organisms. So, we know that how these microorganisms are useful to us. Now, let's break down and study one by one how a particular microorganism is useful to us. Starting off with bacteria. So, let's see how these bacteria are useful to us. Now, they help in decomposing organic waste such as vegetable peels, animal remains, feces, etc. And these bacteria also help in the preparation of medicines. So, you can say that bacteria are really very, very helpful because they help in decomposition of organic waste such as vegetable peels, animal remains, etc. And they also help in preparation of the medicines. Next, bacteria also help to increase the soil fertility by fixing nitrogen. Now, do not worry if you do not know what nitrogen fixing is, because we are going to take up this topic in further lecture. But for now, just understand that fixation of nitrogen means that we are actually converting the nitrogen which is present in environment into a usable form which can be absorbed by the roots. Next, bacteria are also used in setting of curd and making of cheese, pickles and other food items. Like for example, you can see in the animation that is going on your screen that you can actually use the lactobacillus bacteria into the milk to set curd. Now this curd can also help in making idlis or bhaturas, which you people might have eaten. So let's move forward and just tell me that how the formation of curd happens. Now there is a bacteria known as lactobacillus bacteria, which is somewhat like this, and it multiplies in milk and converts that particular milk into curd. And this is a simple process of formation of curd. Now let's move forward and see that what are the various uses of fungi. And in this particular one, we are going to study about the uses of yeast. So let's see what are the uses of yeast. Now yeast is used in baking industry to make bread, pastry, cakes, because it helps in fermentation. Now it reproduces rapidly and produces carbon dioxide during respiration process. Bubbles of carbon dioxide gas is produced and it fills the spaces indoor and increases its volume. As you can see that the CO2 is actually increasing the volume of the dough. Now in this picture you can see that how the yeast is growing super super fast. Let's move forward and see one more use of yeast. Now yeast is also used in commercial production of alcohol and wine, which is done by growing yeast on natural sugars present in fruit juices and grains like your rice, wheat and barley. So this is exactly how the formation of alcohol occurs, and this is the process that is shown on your screen. Now can anyone tell that what is this process of fermentation that is actually responsible for production of your wine, or you can say your alcohol? Now fermentation is a process by which yeast converts sugar into alcohol, and it was discovered by famous personality Louis Pasteur in 1857. I hope you people have understood that what is fermentation. So now, try out this activity on your own. What you need to do is, you need to take 1/2 kg of flour and then you have to add some sugar, mix it with warm water and add small amount of yeast in it. Then you have to knead a soft dough out of it and observe after 2 hours. After 2 hours, the dough will look somewhat like that. That is, it will be more and more fluffy. Now, what is going to be the outcome of this activity? This activity will actually give you a visual effect and a show that after you have actually added yeast and sugar and water, the fermentation is actually happening and CO2 is producing. And because of the production of CO2, your dough will be fluffy. So just go and try it out. Now let's move on to antibiotics. So what are antibiotics and what are their uses? So now antibiotics are medicines that can kill or stop the growth of disease-causing microorganisms. Let's see an example, that is penicillin. Now, do you guys know that in 1929, Alexander Fleming was working on a culture of disease-causing bacteria, and suddenly he finds the spores of little green mold in one of his cultural plates. He observes that, and the presence of mold prevented the growth of the bacteria. In fact, it also killed many of the bacteria. From this mold, the penicillium was produced, And this is the mold that I was talking about in the first place. How interesting. Now let's see what are the uses of antibiotics. So, antibiotics can actually cure a variety of diseases, and they can actually cure them. Some of the antibiotics available are streptomycin, erythromycin, and tetracycline that are made from bacteria and fungi. Now, they can cure microbial infection in animals by mixing antibiotics with feed of livestock and poultry. They can also control several plant diseases. So, this is how antibiotics are very, very helpful to us. But there are some precautions which we should take while taking antibiotics. And why are these precautions? Because sometimes the dose can go a little bit up or down, and that can cause so many side effects to people. Therefore, we should take so many precautions while taking antibiotics. Now, antibiotics should be taken only on the advice of the doctor, and one must complete the course that the doctor prescribes. Antibiotics taken in wrong doses may make the body resistant to the drug, and it may not be effective in the future. Moreover, antibiotics may also kill the beneficial bacteria in the body. Please note one important thing, that antibiotics cannot cure cold and flu that are caused by viruses. Now let's move further and talk about vaccines. Now vaccines are weakened or dead disease-causing microbes that are injected in our body to trigger the production of antibodies. These antibodies remain in the body for a long time to protect it against any attack of disease-causing microbes. Now, antibodies are substances our body produces to fight disease-causing microbes, and the process that is shown on your screen of protecting the body from pathogens with the help of vaccines is called vaccination. So, on your screen, there is this process that is shown on. This is the process of how a vaccination is produced. You can see that it's a whole path in which the scientists and the doctors actually have to do a lot of research and find out a particular vaccination for a particular disease. Now, can you people name some of the diseases that can be prevented by vaccines? Well, if you cannot remember any of the diseases, do not worry, because I'll tell you a few. First, we can say cholera. Next, we have smallpox. Next, we have hepatitis. And lastly, we are going to talk about tuberculosis. Now, one can get the necessary vaccines for the mentioned diseases from nearby hospitals. Lastly, let's talk that how these microbes clean up the environment and how do they do it. Now, microbes or microorganisms decompose organic waste and dead remains of plants and animals and convert them into simpler substances, which can again be used by other plants and animals by the process of biodegradation. Thus, they help us in getting rid of harmful and smelly substances and clean up the environment. I hope you people can relate as to how these microbes are our friends. We will take up the remaining portion of the chapter in upcoming videos. Till then, you can go to EduRef, and then you can go to Science Class 8, then the microorganism section, that is Friends and Foe. And finally, when you will go to the microorganism section, Friends and Foe, you can find various tests, documents, and videos there. Now, if you go to the test bar, you will have so many tests there. Just attempt and find out how much you understood. You can also unlock all the log videos, documents, and tests for Class 8 with EduRev Infinity Plan and ace your exam at less than 80 rupees per month. Thank you.